Good morning, this is Kasturi Day. Today I'm going to discuss the sum of the left rest of the question answers of this chapter of the transport of food and minerals in plants chapter. Okay, so let me start with first is what is translocation? Sugar molecules, we know that sugar molecules are being manufactured in the green leaves of the plant. Okay, this is manufactured, these sugar molecules are manufactured during photosynthesis. Okay, so they need to be transported. So the leaves have manufactured it, but it has to be transported to the other parts of the plant. Excuse me. So these are transported throughout the plant by the phloem tissue. Now the transport of the soluble products of photosynthesis, that is the sugar molecules, is known as translocation of food, or simply translocation. Now name any two micronutrients, that is boron and manganese. Name a disease in plant caused by the deficiency of zinc, that is chlorosis. Next is, what do you understand by active transportation of minerals? Normally, what happens, mineral molecules are more concentrated inside the root hair cells than in the soil outside. Okay, so in the root hair cells, there are more minerals than in the outside, than the minerals which are outside the cell, that is in the soil. So still the root hair cells, they absorb minerals. And for this, what happens, mineral ions move from a region of their lower concentration, that is from the soil where there is concentration of minerals are low. From there, they move to the region of their high concentration, that is inside the root hair cells where the mineral concentration is more. Okay, and that requires the use of energy in the form of ATP. So this is active transport and this is the opposite of diffusion. Okay, next is, explain the relationship between absorption and transpiration. There is a direct relationship between absorption and transpiration. Okay, as water is lost through transpiration, more water is absorbed as more water is required. We know more water is absorbed through transpiration, more water will be absorbed. Okay. So this creates a suction pressure which pulls up water from the xylem of the roots to the stem and to the leaves. This is transpiration pull. So this is due to the transpiration pull, what happens, there is suction pressure created inside the xylem of the stem and which pulls the water from the roots to the soil to the roots by the root hair cells to the roots. Okay, now the amount of water in the roots get reduced. In turn, water from the surrounding soil passes into the root hair cells by osmosis, and this cycle continues. If water is lost through the transpiration more quickly, then more water is absorbed by the root hair cells, and the plant cells tend to lose water, which leads to wilting of leaves. Okay. If this is not done, that is, if the transpiration is more than the water is absorbed, than the amount of water which is absorbed by the root hair cells, then what happens, to reduce the transpiration, the plant cells will wilt, will droop down. The leaves, the stem, the flowers, they all will droop down, leading to wilting. So that they decrease the surface area so that there is less transpiration. Okay, so there is a direct relationship between absorption and transpiration. Now, how does the food manufactured in the leaves reach different parts of the plant? Okay, the sugar molecules, we know that they are manufactured in the green parts of the plant, especially the leaves during photosynthesis. They are transported by the phloem tissue. Okay, and that is translocation process. So phloem has cells, that is sieve tubes, which are placed one above the other to form their long tubes, and through which the food is transported to the various parts of the plant. Next is, give 2 points of importance of transpiration in plants. So it produces cooling effect. Another is, it produces helps in the ascent of sap and distribution of minerals. So first is cooling effect. When there is a rapid loss of water vapor from the aerial parts of the plant, the temperature of the plant or around the plant, it reduces down because it produces a cooling effect to the plant. Then ascent of sap and distribution of minerals, what happens? The transpiration results in the development of low water potential in the leaf tissues. Okay, transpiration, when there is loss of water from the excess water from the leaves, from the stomata of the leaves. So inside the leaves, the water potential becomes low. And thus, water moves from the xylem tissue to the leaf cells. And that helps in the ascent of sap. Okay, that is mineral ions with water. The mineral ions also move up along with water due to this transpiration pull. Okay, now the difference between macronutrients and micronutrients. Okay, so micronutrients are, they are required in minute quantities, whereas macronutrients, they are required in large quantities. Micronutrients play a crucial role in the prevention of diseases, and macronutrients, they play a crucial role in providing energy. Okay. Then micronutrients, their dry weight in the plant of the plant is 0.1 to 0.02% approx. Whereas macronutrients, they are 0.2 to 0.4% approx dry weight. They micronutrients are called trace elements, and macronutrients are also called major elements. Then micronutrients example are boron, manganese, chlorine, iron, zinc, copper, nickel and molybdenum. Whereas macronutrients are nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, sulfate, calcium and magnesium. Okay. Next is, discuss the ascent of sap with the help of neatly labeled diagrams. Okay. So first what happens, root hair cells absorb mineral salts mainly by active transport and they reach the root cortex. That is from the epidermis of the root, they go to the root cortex. Now, the root hair cells absorb water from the soil through osmosis. So, it has absorbed mineral salts through active transport and water through osmosis. They're all moving towards the cortex now. Now, as mineral salts gets accumulated in the xylem, the water concentration gets reduced in it, which is producing a concentration gradient, which is creating a concentration gradient. That concentration gradient is strong enough to draw water and minerals and to move it into the stem. And this creates a pressure, which is known as root pressure, developed in the roots, so that there is continuous inflow of water because due to the concentration and because there is a continuous inflow of water which is helping the sap to move upwards. That is root pressure. Next is, now water moves through the xylem up the stem, then to the leaves due to the pull which is created by the transpiration. That is transpiration pull. Now the water and minerals absorbed by the roots are conducted upwards through the xylem and to the other parts of the plant, that is the stem, leaves and flowers. This is ascent of sap. Okay, so this is the diagrammatic representation. This is a sunny day. There is transpiration of water vapor from the stomata, exerts a pull on the water column in the xylem and draws the sap upwards. Okay, so first is root absorb water through the soil by osmosis and absorb minerals by active transport. Okay, then there is a root pressure which pushes the sap to the stem. Then the water column is sustained in the xylem by the cohesion between the water molecules. So there is cohesion between the water molecules and that is creating a column inside the xylem and water is continuously flowing upwards. And there is also a transpiration pull which is also creating the water which is pulling the water column in the xylem and draws up the sap. So this is ascent of sap in the plants. Okay, due to the transpiration pull. So this is the end of this chapter. If you have any doubt or any other questions beside these of regarding this chapter, please do write in the comment box, or you can also give suggestions to improve my videos, or you can also write in the email ID, email address, and also If you have liked the video, press the like button so that I can produce you some more enthusiastic videos. And if you are a new viewer to my channel or not subscribed yet, please do subscribe to get the notification of my next video. Thank you.